Hello everyone, my name is Devasish Mukherjee. This is EC252, that is Digital Electronic Circuit. It has three lectures, 1, 2 and 1 lab. Okay? And this is a 5 lecture, 5 credit subject. So, by starting, the subject is digital electronic circuit. So, first we will have to decide what is digital. Now, if we say something about right wristwatch, if it is, suppose it is of analog type, analog is the opposite of digital. Suppose it is of Titan watch, so if that point will be continuum, that means it will take every point or every point is visible. That means we don't jump, we can see every point it is moving. There is three hands generally, hour, minute and second. So every three hands of this watch will move and we can see the continuity of this watch. That means every point it will exist. If it is going from here to there, so every point it exists. That is what we say about analog. So analog means when it is continuous. And there is another thing which is our subject, that is digital. Digital is, you can say, there is some state or it is not continuous. Like in case of digital watch, if we say that suppose it is showing 01, that is hour, then suppose minute, after colon suppose it is 30 minutes, so 1 3, then it is showing the second, then suppose after second it is showing the 100, that is fraction of 1 second, 100 fraction of 1 second, that is showing. So that part will continue very fast. That fraction of second, this portion will first, it will move very fast, and then second point, second whatever the display, it will proceed, then minute, then hour, like that. But and it is generally is done by 7 segment display. 7 segments means here we can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 7 segment display which is giving like 1 8 symbol. So that is our structure. So suppose this is for hour, this is for minute, this is for second, and this is for fraction of second. Now, so we can see in any of these 7 segment display, it can be displayed from 0 to 9. For example, if at any time 2 is hour, time is suppose minute, 70 milliseconds, and the fraction of second suppose it is 88. So its next will be 89, then it will be 90, like that. So this is fraction of second, which is if we divide 1 second to 100 parts, 1 part we are taking in increment, 88 to 89, 89 to 90. So this is the increment. So though it is very very less, that means 1 part, if we divide 1 second to 100 parts, and 1 part we can count, so we can count very minutely, that is okay. But the thing is, after 88, it will go 89. That is a part of second, I am telling. But in between 88 and 89, suppose it is 88.2, then also it will show 88. Suppose it is 88.4, then also it will show 88. Suppose it is 88.7, then it will show 89. If it is 88.8, then also it will show 89. If it is 88.9, then also it will show 89. That means though it is very minor part, but we cannot distinguish. That means this part is omitted. That means after 88, next point is 89. So there is some step, 88 to 89, there is some step, like if it is 02, next will be 03, so after 2 it is 3, so there is some step. So if there is particularly predefined step, then it is digital. If it is continuous, that means every point we are having some data, then it will be continuous and it will be treated as analog. For example, suppose with respect to time, I am plotting the curve of a sinusoidal waveform. Now this sinusoidal waveform is present at every stage, at every point of time. So this we call continuous. But in another signal, suppose it is pulse signal. So in pulse signal, from here to here, no signal is present. Here signal is present. At this stage, no signal is present. Here again signal is present. Here signal is not present. Here signal is present. That means, at particular point, we are having the data. But the data is not continuous. So that kind of representation, when we are having some predefined stages, at which point values are given, at another point values are not given, that is called digital. Next is electronic circuit. So in electronic circuit, what we are doing? We generally indicate IC. That means if in any circuit there is any IC, or in other words we can say if there is some active device, if there is some active device that is called electronic circuit. The difference between electronic circuit and electrical circuit is that if there is at least one active circuit present in the circuitry, we call it electronic circuit. If no active device is there, we call it passive. We call it that if all the circuits, all the devices are passive only, then we call it electric circuit. So electric and electronic, the difference is at least one active device should be there. Active device means generally if any current, the flow of current in any device, if we can control electrically, that is we call active device. Okay. Now I will start different number system. For example, what we generally in general life we use decimal number system. So decimal number system is up to 0 to 9. From 0 to 9, if we are taking the digits which we use in normal life, this is called decimal number system. So after 9, it will be 10 and so on. There are, so its base is 10, that is decimal number system, the base is 10. If we are using some other number system which we will study, for example, one very popular number system used for computer or electronic circuit is binary. In case of binary, our base is 10, our base is 2. Decimal base is 10, binary base is 2. In case of binary, there is only 2 digits is present, that is 0 and 1. So if we want to make it beyond this, we have to make it 2 digits, because in 1 digit only 0 or only 1 can be there, it cannot be more than that. So only 2 values are possible. If it is of single digit, that is 0 and 1, so binary base is 2. Now suppose, and this is decimal, so 0 belongs to 0, 1 belongs to 1. Next, for decimal number 2, if we want to make binary, we have to make it 2 digits. Now, if we make 2 digits, and if we make the starting digit 0, second digit anyone, then it is not 2 digits because left side 0 has no value. Left side 0 has no value. So it is again converted to single digit only. So that means our first digit, or what we say, leftmost digit, must be 1. So if we have to make it 2 digits, first is 1. So second is either 0 or 1, so minimum is 0. So this is the equivalent of 2. If we want to make 3 is decimal number, and if we want to make the equivalent binary, after 1 0, next is this 0 we can increment, so it is 1 1. Next, for 4, again it is not possible because in 2 digits 1 1 is the highest possible number. So we have to go to 3 digits. We have no other choice. We have to go to 3 digits. So again, first digit is 1. So we have to take another 2 digits. Minimum is 0 0. So that is in binary. If I take 1 0 0, this is the binary of decimal number 4. If we are taking decimal number 5, it will be 101. This is the after 100, the next value is 101. For 6, it will be 01. So next we have to increment. So this is 10. 7, we can write 111. 1. If we want to increase again, that is, if we want decimal 8, we have no other choice but we have to go to 4 digits. So for 4 digits, our first number is 1 0 0 0. Then we can go 1 0 0 1. Then we can go 1 0 1 0. Then we can go 1 0 1 1. Again for 12, we can do 1 1 0 0. For 13, we can do 1 1 0 1. For 14, we can do 1 1 1 0. For 15, we can do 1 1 1 1. And this power is like 1 2 4 8. That means this power is 1, this power is 2, this power is 4, this power is 8. So if we add 8 plus 4, 12, 13, 14 and 15, it is coming 15. So that is what we call power of any number. For example, in decimal, suppose we write 5731. So 5731 is decimal number, and in this decimal number we call it 5731. So now this 5 is 5 only, but we are calling this 5000. So that means its power is 1000. Okay. Next, it is 700, so its power is 100. Its power is 10, its power is 1. So it's 1, 10, 100, 1000. So this is the power 1, 10, 100, 1000. So if we want to make this in any formula, we can write like this: 1, that is 10 to the power 0. Anything power 0 is 1. This is 10 to the power 1, this is 10 to the power 2, this is 10 to the power 3. So this is normal decimal number. But the same formula, that is to the power 0, to the power 1, to the power 2, to the power 3, that is valid for any number system. Only thing is, here the base is 10, normal decimal number is 10 base. So we will have to change this 10 with whatever the base of another number system. Another number system is octal. In octal, the base is 8. That means 0 to 7 we are having the digits. So now we cannot say 8 because 8 is not there in octal. Octal is base 8, so its maximum will be, it will from 0 to 7, so maximum will be 7. After then, if we want to increase, so we have to go to 2 digits because up to 7 all the digits are complete. So we have to go to second digit. So second digit means leftmost we cannot do 0. So leftmost at least we have to do 1. If we do more than 1, it will be higher number. So least possible is 1. Then it is 0. So this is the equivalent of decimal 8. After this, we can do 1, 1. So this is equivalent to decimal 9. After this, we can repeat all these numbers, that is 12, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, which will be corresponding decimal number 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and so on. So if in octal it is up to 0, from 0 to 7 up to 7, then we have 2 digits. Another number system is hexadecimal. In hexadecimal, the base is 16. The base is 16. But the difference is from 0 to 9, it is having the normal number. After this, it is not 10. After this, it is not 10. It is 8. So this is A. Next is B, C, D, E, F. So it will go A to F. So 0 to 9, then A to F. This is total 16 number. So this is called hexadecimal number system. Okay, so in this case 0 to 9, this is the normal number system. So 0 to 9 is same. This is equivalent to decimal number 10, this is 11, this is 12, this is 13, this is 14, this is 15. So 0 to 15, but we are representing from 0 to 9 and A to A. So this is 0 to 15, this is hexadecimal. Next, Next, we will do some revision of logic gates. Our first logic gate is AND, and this is the symbol of AND. This two is input, this is output. So this is suppose we are denoting by A, B and C. So if we have the truth table, if it is 0, 0, both the input is 0, 0 or low or false, output is 0. If it is 0, 1 or 1, 0, that means one input is true, another input is false, then also its output is false or 0. If both are true, then only the output is true. So for any AND gate to become the output true, we have to provide both the input as true or 1. If any one input is not true, that is false or 0, if any one input is 0, the output will be 0. If any one input is 0, output will be 0. Both the input 0, output is 0. If both the input is 1, output is 1. Next is OR gate. So this is the symbol of OR gate. Here, if any one of the input is true or 1, output will be 1. So if both input is 0, output is 0. If any one input is 1, output is 1. And if both the output input is 1, output is obviously 1. So for OR, the output to become 1, at least one input must be 1, which is the opposite case of AND gate. In case of AND, if any one input is 0, output is 0. But in case of OR, if any one input is 1, output is 1. Next gate is NOT, which does inversion. So if input is 1, output is 0. If input is 0, output is 1. So we will get just the opposite or reverse if we are providing input to NOT. Next gate is NAND. NAND is if we do NOT operation after AND operation, this becomes NAND gate. So this is equal to AND gate plus NOT gate. This is the symbol of AND. If we put a bubble there, it is NAND gate. So again, if we are doing the truth table, if it is 0, 0, AND output will be 0, but NAND output will be 1, that is opposite of AND. So 0, 0, AND output is 0, NAND output is 1. 0, 1 or 1, 0, AND output is 0, but NAND output is reverse of 0, that is 1. If anyone is 0, AND becomes 0, but NAND becomes 1, that is opposite of that. If both are 1, 1, if AND operation is 1, so NAND operation is 0. So this is just the opposite of the truth table of AND gate. So NAND is opposite of AND gate. Next is NOR gate. Just like NAND is opposite of AND, similarly NOR is opposite of OR. That means if the output of OR gate is again passed to a NOR gate, it becomes NAND gate. And the symbol is also having the bubble. This is OR gate. If you take a bubble, it becomes NOR gate. If both the input is 0, OR output is 0, NOR output is 1. If any one input is 1, if any of the input is 1, then OR will be 1, so NOR will be 0. If both the input is 1, then OR operation will be 1, so NOR operation will be 0. So this is the opposite of OR operation, it is called NOR gate. Next is XOR or exclusive OR gate. In XOR gate, if both the input is opposite, in XOR gate, if both the input is opposite to each other, then output will be 1, otherwise output will be 0. Same input, output is 0. Opposite input, so output is 1 in both the cases. If both the input is opposite to each other, that they vary from each other, output will be 1. If both the input is 1, output is again 0. So this is exclusive OR. Next gate is XNOR or exclusive NOR. This is opposite of exclusive OR gate. In case of exclusive OR gate, both input is different, output is 1. Here output is 0. That means same input, both input are same. So in case of XOR, output is 0, but XNOR output is 1. If both input is different, then in case of XOR gate, output is 1, here output is 0, that is opposite. If again both input is same, so XOR is output will be 0, here output is 1. So this is the truth table of XNOR. Among these, NAND and NOR, these two gates is called universal gate. These two gates are called universal gate. The reason is we can make any gate, that is, we can make the truth table of any gate, or we can have the operation of any gate, any logic gate, by using only NAND or using only NOR gate. That means, if we use only NAND gate, we can make the circuit which having the truth table equivalent to either AND, either OR, either NOT any gate. So NAND gate can be used to be equivalent of any gate. Using NAND gate, we can make circuitry of any other gate. Using NOR gate, only NOR gate, we can use circuitry of any other gate. So both these gates are called universal gates. If we are provided only NAND gate or only NOR gate, then we can make all the gates, all whatever the gates are there, all the gate operations we can have. Next, we will do next we will make some circuit which having multiple gates. So we now, up to now we have seen the gate, single gate output. Now we will see if multiple gate is there, how it can have the output. Suppose this is one AND gate. This is OR gate. This means there is connection, so we are having the same input. This represents they don't have touch. They are different lines. This is one above another, but they don't have connection. Here they have connection. Now we have to take the truth table of this circuit which having three different gates. Now, so far as we have three inputs, so that means it is three digits. That combination will be added. That is 000, 001, 010, 011, 100 101 110 111. So we can see 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. Just a minute. 0 0 1. Yeah. All this combination we are having as input. Now we have to apply this input with A, B, and C, and we have to check what may be the output. First case is 0 0 0. If both are 0 and we have 0, if both is 0, or we'll also have 0. If both have same input, so excluding or will have 0. So this will have as 0 output. Next is 001. This is same 01, or operation will be 1. Now both the input is different, so output will be, exact output will be 1. So it is 1. Next case is 010. So 0 and 1, and operation is same 0, 1 and 0, or is also same 1. So output, both the input is different to XOR, so output is 1. So this is also 1. Next is 011. One thing, as we are having 3 digits, as we are having 3 inputs, so it is 3 digits. So maximum possible number that we are having, okay, that is 8, that is 2 to the power 3 equal to 8, 2 to the 3 equal to 8. Now we can have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We can have 8 number of combination. If it is 3 input, for binary we can have 8 number of combinations. Our number system is binary, so it is combination of 0 1, so base is 2. We are having 3 input, so this is the power, so 8 combinations we can have. So we can have 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. It is 8 combinations. Next is 011. 01 and is 0, 11 or is 1, so 01 different, so it will be 1. So for 011 also output is 1. Next is 100. One and 0 and operation will have 0. 00 all operation will have 0. Same input, so output will be 0. So this will be 0. Next combination is 101. For 101, we can have 1 and 0. This is same. 0 and 1, this will be 1. So this output will be 1. This is for 101. This is 101. Output is 1. Next is 110. So we have to change this to 110. For 110, if both input is 1 to AND gate, output will be 1. So after long time we are having 1 here. 0 and 1 and 0, all operations will be 1. So both have same input, output will be 0. So it is 0. And the last combination is 111. And both input is 1, output is 1. Or both input is 1, output is obviously 1. Same input to XOR, output will be 0. So this is, if we are having any arbitrary circuit having multiple gates, how we can write the truth table. We know that truth table of any single gate, but if we are asked to give truth table of combination of gates, we have to figure it out at which input for will be the output. So this is the truth table of 3 input combination of different gates, and we are having this output. Next is conversion of decimal to binary. Conversion of decimal to binary. Suppose we are having one number. I can have one number directly I am writing. Suppose 110.11. This we have to convert. This we have to convert to decimal. So first we will say, just we already have seen that if we are taking this decimal number, we are suppose taking any decimal number, so its power will be 10 to the power 0, its power is 10 to the power 1, its power is 10 to the power 2, its power is 10 to the power 3. And after this point, that is up to the right side of this point, this will be 10 to the power minus 1, 10 to the power minus 2, like this. This is the in case of normal decimal number. Same thing we can follow for any number system. Only thing is this base. For example, this decimal base we are having 10. This we have to change to whatever base we are using. In this case, it is binary number, so we are using base of 2. So we can have, in spite of this 10, we will have 2. Before 2 point, we can have its power 2 to the power 0, its power 2 to the power 1, its power 2 to the power 2, its power 2 to the power 3, its power 2 to the power 4. Same as decimal, only the base we have to change. So in spite of 10, we are writing 2 here. And this is 2 to the power minus 1, 2 to the power minus 2, like that. So if we are converting this, we have to see what is so its value is 0 multiplied by 2 to the 0, so it will be 0. This one is its power is 2 to the power 1, that is 2, multiplied by 1, so it is 2. This is 0 multiplied by 2 to the power 2, so again multiplied by 0, so it is 0. It is 1 multiplied by 2 to the power 3, so here we have to multiply. So 2 to the power 3 we have to multiply by 1, so that means multiplied by 1, it is 8, and here it is 16 multiplied by 1, so it is 16. So we have to add this one, 0 plus 2 plus 8 plus 16, so it is 16 plus 8, 26. This one if we add, it becomes 26. And here it is 2 to the power minus 1, that is half. 2 to the power minus 1 means 1 by 2, that is multiplied by 1, so it is half. Half means 0.5. So this is 0.5 because it is after point, and this is 2 to the power minus 2. Okay, so 2 to the power minus 2 means it is 1/4, and 1/4 means this is 0.25. 1 by 4, 2 to the power minus 2 means it is 1 by 4. If it is 1 by 4, that means it is 0.25. So this is 0.5, this is 0.25. So if we add, it is 0.75. So this is 0.75. So in total, we are having 26.75. So this is the process how we can convert any binary number to decimal number. So equivalent of 110.10.11 is 26.75. Some important combination for binary number. If we write 2 to the power 10, it is kilo or k. If it is 2 to the power 20, it is mega or m. If it is 2 to the power 30, then it is giga or g. If it is 2 to the power 40, then it is tera or t. So this is in binary what we call kilo 210, mega 220, giga 230, tera 2 to the power 40. Next, we will do the addition in binary. Addition in binary. Suppose 2 number which we have to add, 1 and 1. Okay, before to that, suppose normal addition, if you do 9 and 2 is 11, 1 is carry which goes to here, 5 is 7 and 1 is 8. This is normal decimal operation. 9 plus 2 is 11, that is 2 digits. If it is 2 digits, 1 is here, another one goes to 10, that is 5 to 8, 5 to 7, and 1 candidate is 8. Same thing we can do here. 1 and 1, its value is 1, 0, because 1 and 1 is 2, binary equivalent of 2 is 1, 0. So 0 is here and the 1 will go to carry. So 1 and carry 1, again it is 0, carry 1, 1 and 1, again it is 0, carry 1, 1 and 1, again it is 0, carry 1, 1 and 1, again it is 0, carry 1, 1 and 1, again it is 0, carry 1, 1 and 1, again it is 0, carry 1, 1, 1, 1, so it is 1, 1. So, only two things we have to remember. If it is 0 plus 1, it is 1. If it is 1 plus 1, it is 1, 1. Among this one will remain and this one will remain and this one will go to carry for next one. And if it is already 1, 1 and we are having a carry 1, so it is addition of 1, 1, 1, so it is actually, 1 is 1, 0, 1 is 1, 0, so 0 will be here, 1 will go to carry, 1, 1, 1, we have double 1, so 1 will be here and 1 will go to carry. That is 0 and 1, 1. If it is both are 1, if both are 1, then it is 1, 0. So 0 will remain, 1 will go to carry. If all the, if 2 is 1 and the third one is carry, so whatever is 2, 3, 1. So it is 1, 1. So this one we have to keep and this one is going as carry. Same thing. 1, 1, so it is 1, 0, 0 is where, here, 1 go to carry. So, 1 and 1, so it is 1, 0, 0 is there, 1 go to carry. 1 and 1, 0 there, 1 will go to carry. 1 and 1, 0 there, 1 go to carry. 1 and 1, 0 there, 1 go to carry. 1 and 1, 0 there, 1 go to carry. 1, 1, 0. 1 will carry, get 3, 1, so it is 1, 1, so 1 here and 1 is carry, nothing is there, so 1 is there. So this is how we do binary addition. Next, binary subtraction, we will continue in next class. Thank you.